Hi guys! Hi 3D printer enthusiasts, hi makers, and hi recycled goods. Today I want to show you how you can make a totally recycled filament with Felfil Evo, starting from PLA scraps, okay? Obtained by Felfil Evo. I can show you. As you can see, all the pieces are not to be of the same dimension. They just to be small enough to enter into Felfil. Okay? So, on the left of Felfil, you can see all the brushes. We transform with Felfil Evo these PLA pellets, and this is a raw material, into Felfil, into 3D printed filament. Then, we print our two pieces hopper, the hopper inside Felfil Evo. Okay? And as you know, often print fails. So we have an amount of material that we can recycle. And with a blender, we reduce it to scraps. And then I'm gonna show you how you can reuse it, okay? Allora, so my Felfil Evo is already hot. I can go back to the temperature window in order to show you that you have to set it around 180 degrees, because this PLA, we work with PLA ever in a window of temperature, in a range temperature about 175-186. So you can see that the Felfil Evo has already reached this temperature, and you can see it because the material, our chamber and our skew, are already full of material, because this is the Felfil Evo you usually work with. It's not a brand new Felfil Evo. Then, after all the extrusion, you can you have some materials that stay inside the melting chamber and the screw. And as you can see, it also could be a large amount of material. Then, when you start to use Felfil again after an extrusion, oops, just wait a while in order to melt down completely the material inside the chamber, okay? And usually you can see a little pieces of filament go out of the nozzle when the material inside the chamber is well melted. So, now we can go to try to extrude this material. First of all, I have to put it inside the Felfil Evo hopper. This is totally empty, okay? Then, we can put some of this inside. So now the quantity is not really important. I just want to show you how to set it. But we can also totally pull the hopper. Okay. So done. Then I'm in the first RPM window. And now I have to set the RPM. Oh, first of all, please note that the Felfil Evo works better if you put it on the edge of the table. You can use its rubber feet as a reference, okay? Then we can go set the RPM. Usually we start to 6, 7. That is a good ratio of RPM. You can consider that usually with the 1.75 filament, we work with the with 6-7 RPM. With 2.85 filament, we usually work with 8-9 RPM, which is the top speed. And I also want to tell you that the lower speeds, like 3, 4, 5, are almost for a special material like TPU or similar. That is a little bit stronger than this too. However, we can see that the power consumption of the motor right now is a little behind, but hopefully it's gonna reduce it during the extrusion now, yeah, just to set it. You can see that the filament is already quite consistent, and of course before measuring it we have to
to wait that it reach the floor, and it becomes to make a spear and collect it. Okay, so this is the first step we have to do. A small precision is that if you work with a really old PLA, probably you have to dry it a little. Okay, you can use a food dryer or a special dryer. And it could be a food, really. Okay? Now, as you can see, Felfil has started making filaments. We have just to wait a while until it really reaches the floor. Okay? As you can see, we just put Felfil on the table and the extruder down from the table. You don't need to put any kind of fan, water cooling, or something else to stabilize the to get the filament consistent. Simply because we designed this special nozzle that works exactly at the opposite of the outend. So the filament cool down during the extrusion, and before the out, he has a cool down his temperature. Okay, this is why you can't find any kind of fan in front of the filament. And now, as you can see, we are extruding on the floor, and some people on the internet ask us for a spooler. Okay, a spooler is a good idea, of course. Could be helpful, but virtually it can't help to reach more stable results. Because ideally you can obtain the power tolerance just with Felfil Evo and finding the right settings. However, with a spooler, all the job will become more comfortable because you have not to collect it by hand on a spool after you make extrusion. So now. Felfil Evo is actually working well. Now we can gonna see to, we're gonna try to measure it a little in order to make the first adjusting of Felfil Evo filament. Okay, so this is the first meter and a half, and we can also touch it without any feeling to make a mess. Okay, this is a good one. We are a really little thin filament. So what I suggest is you can make the same operation with two different choices. You can increase the RPM or decrease the temperature. Okay. We can see that power consumption of the gear motor is about 1 ampere, so it's on the half of its full load. And we can try to increase the temperature. Now we have 6 RPM, let's try with 7. Quite a while in order to be sure that it's not not activate the protection region of the field. And then we can wait a while, then measure it again and adjust again the settings. Now we have 7 RPM. The speed, the extrusion ratio is good enough. Is almost at the same with the new material, raw material. I also make another precision, is that when you work with your static PLA, the work is a little bit harder than when you work with the new one. This is almost true for almost all the polymers. But if you with the ABS can add a part of with ABS, you have to add the 20% of raw material in order to stabilize the filament. With PLA it helps, but I'm trying to show you it's not fundamental. So the extrusion ratio is okay. The measure looks still a little bit tiny. I can make a check fast. And we are at 1.55 millimeters. So At this point, what I suggest is that if I increase the RPM and the motor consumption remains stable, so I can go to put down the temperature a little bit. Now I'm to 180 degrees. I can try to 175, because we have still a gap between the measure and the filament, and our goal it is still a little bit, so we can also use 5 dB. Okay, it's working well. Okay, now I'm gonna to exit from the camera in order to show you a little bit of how it's collecting on the core. So guys, now we have made some meters of filament, okay? We can say that is about 20 meters, 30 meters, 30 meters, okay. So, we can go to take some measure and decide if it's okay. Now, we are at 1.72, that is super okay. 1.72. 1.71. 1.67, 1.74, 1.86, okay? This is, however, this is in our... this is the range we need to print. This is the correct range. So, now, I'm going to stop with Felfil Evo. I'm going to cut this filament, and I'm going to put this filament inside our printers. And I will show you that it's a good filament to print. So, please note that the spirals are not so consistent, they're not so regular. Because this is full recycled material, and then the angle is a little bit different from the totally wrong one. However, we think this is good enough to make some prints. In order to continue our extrusion, we can simply cut. I suggest to keep one spiral in order to make the filament still work, okay? Then, remember to take the starting filament wire, okay? Then, I can go to the printer. So guys, now that printer are finished, this is your 3D Pro medal made in 100% recycled PLA filament, and so we make some conclusion at the end of this video. We say that Felfil is suitable for novice and for expert, and I confirm that. Simply because you have to know that 3D print and extrusion are two totally different fields. So, also if you are a 3D pro, as the meta says, is not automatically that you are also an extruder pro, okay? So, if you are a novice, you will be always a novice if you never use a filament extruder. Then you have to have the patience to learn, to try, retry, to experiment. And then, this is what we have to say about recycled filament with Felfil Evo.
Thanks for watching and bye.